welcome tonight's top answer. It's Vernon Kay.
To a brand new series of Family Fortunes. Now, it may be brand new, but some things are too sacred to mess with. Just like before, we've surveyed 100 normal, everyday people, but judging by some of their answers, it's probably 97 normal people and a few complete and utter loonies. And, of course, we've still got the... Oh! We love it. Now, some things have changed. There's a brand new sparkly screen and a brand new sparkly host. And this time, our families are celebrity families playing for up to 30 grand for their favourite charity, as well as their self-respect. So let's meet them. See if you can work out who gets the comfy chair in this house.
Hi, Vernon. I'm Dad.
Hi, Vernon. I'm Mum.
Hi, Vernon. I'm the aunt.
And this is Will.
Welcome to our family home.
Well, what can I tell you about our daughter? This used to be her bedroom.
From a very young age, she was pretty keen on fashion. Some of it was pretty dodge, like these. And then there was the art phase.
We're very proud of our daughter, and she's certainly come a long way since her early days of performing.
She also loved music, especially a band called Hanson, who she was absolutely crazy about.
She was also partial to a jelly bean or two.
Well, I think we've embarrassed our daughter enough, so we'll see you soon.
Bye.
With your family from Top of the Pops, it's Fern Cotton! Fern.
Hi.
How are you?
Very well. I'm very excited to be here.
That's what we want to hear.
Yeah.
Welcome to Family Fortunes. Yes. Where have you brought your family from?
We are from North West London.
Excellent. Please introduce me to your family.
Okay, this is my dad, Mick.
Hi, Mick.
Hello, Vernon.
This is my mum, Lynn.
Hi, Lynn.
Hi, Vernon.
This is my auntie, Karen.
Hi, auntie Karen.
Hello, Vernon.
And this is my cousin, Jess.
Hi, cousin Jess.
Hi, Vernon. Jess is a girl's name.
Now, tonight's all about charity, Fern. Yep. Which charity are you playing for?
The Macmillan Fund.
Ladies and gentlemen, give them a massive round of applause, the Conn family! Now, I can hear someone else scratching at the door, so let's introduce the second family here tonight. See if you can guess who's king of this castle.
Hi, Vernon. Welcome to our home. I'm Chris, his dad.
And I'm Hannah, his mum. I'd like to tell you about our wonderful son. My son was always the joker, making people laugh and doing impressions.
He started his career at the local radio station when he was 16.
And since then, things have really taken off for him.
Our son's really proud of his Leeds heritage, and he's a massive Leeds supporter, and he gets to as many matches as he can in a season. Our son also has an obsession with sunglasses.
And when he goes shopping, he always has to buy a new pair.
Well, Vernon, I hope that's given you a few clues.
And we're looking forward to Family Fortunes. Bye, Vernon!
Bye, Vernon! Yes, here in his family, please welcome the saviour of Radio 1, Chris Moyles! How are you, Chris?
I'm clapping myself.
Don't worry, you've got nothing to be afraid of.
It's too late.
It's fine, it's fine. I'll tell you what, whatever happens tonight, Chris, yeah, after the show, we'll go to the green room and we'll have a drink.
Just one?
Might be three.
Yay!
Right then, Chris, where have you brought your family from?
I brought them from Leeds and London.
All right, please introduce me to your family.
This is my lovely girlfriend, Sophie.
Hi.
Hello, Vernon.
This is my mum, Hannah.
Hi, Hannah.
Hello, Herman.
This is my legendary dad, the original Chris Moyles.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, Vernon.
I'll tell you what, one more Chris, we'll have an epidemic. Hey!
And finally, at the end, is my older brother, Kieran.
Hi, Kieran.
Hello, Vernon.
All right, Chris, it's all about charity. Which charities are you playing for?
We're playing for two charities, the Robert Ogden Centre, which is in Leeds, and the Ian Rennie Hospice at Home, which is based in Train, the cancer care charities.
Excellent stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, give the Moyles family a massive round of applause! All right, we've got our families, we've got our questions, and we've got security on standby. Chris and Fern, come and join me at the front. Get ready to play at home. It's time for Family Fortunes. Chris, Fern, Fern, Chris.
Hi.
Hi!
I'm sorry.
Ooh. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. We've surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top 7 answers. Every point is worth a pound. Good luck to both families. Name something usually done in the dark. Chris, keep it clean.
Developing photographs.
Is saying developing photographs. Our survey says it's there. Well done. Hang on. It's the third most popular answer. There's two more popular answers.
Shut up. I'm going to say sleep.
All right. Fern's saying sleep. Our survey says yes. Fern's going to play or pass. All right, they're going to play. Chris, back to your family. Start conferring. You might get the chance to steal, no conferring, the Cotton family. Mick, what do you think?
Sleepwalking.
Sleepwalking, something usually done in the dark. Mick's saying sleepwalking.
Fern does it all the time.
Our survey says... it's not there. Don't look it. All right, Lynn. Now, when we introduced Fern, she got a massive, massive round of applause, a huge cheer. But I think that the audience need a bit of guidance. They need a cheerleader, for example. Do you think we've got one in the vicinity?
Oh.
Now, come on, Fern.
Please.
The magic and the joys of television for Family Fortune. Show us your pom-poms.
Very long time, but OK.
Go on.
Family Fortune!
Lynn, name something usually done in the dark.
The cinema, watching a film.
The cinema, watching the film. All right, Lynn is saying the cinema. Our survey says... oh, yes, it's there, well done. Fourth most popular answer, and you've won a spot prize. Congratulations, Lynn. Tonight, you've won this.
Well, Lynn, meet the tiger. Magnificent, exotic, dangerous, and deadly. Well, let's hope not, as we're sending you to Paradise Wildlife Park, where you're getting the chance to feed the tigers by hand. Now, that's what I call cat food.
Well done. All right, Karen, name something usually done in the dark.
Looking at the stars.
Looking at the stars. Stargazing. Looking at the stars. Is it there? It's not there. Moyles family, get ready. You could get the chance to steal. You've lost 2 lives. We're looking for 4 more answers. Jess, what do you think? Something usually done in the dark.
Looking for a light switch.
Looking for a light switch. All right. Jess is saying looking for a light switch. Our survey says... yeah! Well done. Well done, Jeff. Right, Fern, you've got 1 life. You need 3 more answers. What are you thinking? Something usually done in the dark?
Badger watching. I've done it before. It has to be night time. Oh, no.
All right. They never said this would happen when I took the job. We're looking for badger watching. Our survey says... it's not there, Moyles family. Come on, Kieran, what do you think?
Wake up.
Chris?
Bump into things.
Bump into things, Hannah?
Scared.
Scared, yep. Sophie?
Hide.
Chris?
I'm going to choose bump into things.
All right, you're going for bump into things.
Yeah.
For the steal from the Cotton family, Chris Moyles saying bump into things. Our survey said... oh! Well done, Fern. Congratulations. congratulations. You've kept hold of the points. The missing answers we were looking for. Something usually done in the dark. The sixth most popular was... fireworks. Fifth most popular... burglaries. Who did we survey? Strange, ways. And the second most popular answer was... sex. Don't know what that is. All right, after the first game, the Moyles family are yet to score, but the Cottons are in the lead with 71. Mick and Sophie, come and join me down the front. Let's play more Family Fortunes. Come on, Sophie. Soft, make, mix off. Every point's worth a pound, and by your buzzer, one hand behind your back.
Kill him, Sophie! Kill him.
We're looking for the top six answers. Name something people do to cure a hangover. Mick.
Hair of the dog.
Hair of the dog. Mick saying hair of the dog. Our survey says... yes, one of the top answers. Do you want to play our pass, Mick?
Thank you.
We're going to play. All right, Sophie, back to the Moyles family. Start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Now, Lynn, the nation knows Fern... as well as a cheerleader now, but they also know her as kind of a great follower of fashion. She's a trendsetter, but has she always been like that?
Hardly, no. We've had a lovely ensemble, I remember, a curly perm,
no.
And dungarees, and
nice.
Bobber boots.
No!
Oh, well, it's funny you should say that. OK, take a look at this picture, ladies and gentlemen.
No!
There's
no,
the dungarees.
No, no!
And the curly perm.
Look like
very nice.
Look
like a member of the Levellers. take a look at this one if you think that's bad.
Oh,
there you go.
No.
That's a floral ensemble.
That's really not good.
Well, you say that, it's very similar to what you're wearing tonight.
Actually, isn't it?
And finally, look at that shell suit. That's
the shell
suit. Awesome.
Yes.
Absolutely.
How's the shell suit?
Well, you know.
Gotta give it a go.
Exactly. If you don't, never mind. Now then, Lynn, something people do to cure a hangover.
Have a cold shower.
Have a cold shower. Lynn saying, have a cold shower. Our survey says... it's not there. Unlucky, Lynn. Karen, something people do to cure a hangover.
Make themselves sick.
Make themselves sick. Pretty extreme. We're looking for make themselves sick. It's not there. What a surprise. All right, Moyles family, get ready. You might get a chance to steal if Jess messes this up.
Take paracetamol.
Take paracetamol. All right. Jesse's saying take paracetamol, but what did our survey say? Medicine. Well done. All right, we need four more answers. You've got one life left, Fern.
Have a good old fry up.
Have a good old fry up. An English breakfast. All right, we're saying an English breakfast. Our survey says. Yes, well done. Well done. Mick?
Black coffee.
Black coffee. Cup of coffee. Yes. All right. Mick's saying a cup of coffee. Our survey says. Yes! Well done! Well done, Mick. It's guys, the fifth most popular answer. And, of course, that noise means that you have won a prize. Feast your eyes on this, cos it's coming home with you tonight.
Hey, Mick, you can turn them green on the greens with this. Yup, make headway on the fairway and cruise the course with this state-of-the-art Segway golf transporter. It'll carry your golf bags and even whiz you back home again at the end of the game.
Play golf, Mick?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. You can look like a right idiot on your seat. Lynn, what do you think? Something people do to cure a hangover?
Go back to bed. Sleep.
Go back to bed. Have a lie in. All right, Lynn's saying have a lie in. Our survey says... yes, well done. It's there. We're doing really, really well. Karen, we need one more answer, but you've only got one life left. Need an answer, got to hurry up, might hear the buzzer. Oh, time's up, which means you lose a life. Moyles family, are you ready? Kieran, need an answer?
Drink water.
Drink water, Chris?
Same, bud.
Same, Hannah?
Go for a walk.
Let's go for a walk. Sophie?
Drink orange juice.
Drink orange juice, Chris?
I've never had one, I don't really know. I'm gonna say...
I've got to rush you, Chris.
What?
Got to rush you.
Water! I'll have a water!
He's saying water, our survey says... it is! Oh, well done, Chris. That was a great steal from the Cotton family. Well done. Now, at the end of that, that means that the Cotton family have got 71 and the Moyles have just taken the lead with 73, ladies and gentlemen. It's just quick time for me to get me back in place. We'll get your phones ready because in just a short while we'll be giving you the chance to win some big money. We'll see you after the break. Welcome back to Family Fortunes. We're just a few minutes away from finding out who gets the bread and who's just toast. It's the Cotton family versus the Moyles family. Good luck to both our teams. Lynn and Hannah, come and join me at the front. Let's play more Family Fortunes. It's even, Stevens. It's 71 versus 73. Hannah and Lynn, one hand by your buzzer. One hand behind your back. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name something you might wear to disguise yourself as a Frenchman. Lynn.
Beret.
A beret. Lynn saying a beret. Our survey says... We're going to play. OK, Hannah, back to the Moyles family. Start conferring. You might get another chance to steal. Good luck. Name something you might wear to disguise yourself as a Frenchman. Karen?
String of onions around your neck.
A string of onions. Karen's saying onions. Our survey says... Yes, well done. Second most popular answer. We need three answers. We've got all three lives intact. Jess?
Drape yourself in a French flag.
Drape yourself in a French flag. If you were to disguise yourself as a Frenchman, you'd drape yourself in a French flag. Our survey says... Fern, something you might wear to disguise yourself as a Frenchman.
A little moustache.
A little moustache.
Yeah.
All right, Fern's saying a moustache. Our survey said... Yes, well done, it's there. Two lives left, two more answers. Mick, what do you think?
I think a hooped shirt.
A hooped shirt.
Yeah.
Mick's saying a hooped shirt. Our survey says... Yes, well done, start the top. We're looking good. Lynn, we need one answer. We've got two lives left.
You'd be riding a bicycle.
You'd be riding a bicycle. Our survey says... Oh, it's not there! Moyles family, you might get the chance to steal. Start coming up with some answers. Karen, name something you might wear to disguise yourself as a Frenchman.
Black trousers.
Black trousers. Karen saying black trousers. Our survey says... It's not there! Right, Kieran, need an answer quickly.
Raincoat.
A raincoat, Chris.
Cheese and bread.
Cheese and bread. Hannah?
Red wine.
Red wine. Sophie?
Baguette.
A baguette. Chris?
Oh, I don't know French things.
need an answer.
A baguette.
A baguette. All right, for the chance to steal from the Cotton family, Chris and the Moyleses are saying a baguette. Our survey says... Oh, I love it! Well done from Cotton and the family. You managed to hold on to the points. Let's have a look. What was that missing answer? Garlic. All right, after that, the Moyles family have still got 73, but the Cottons are just in the lead with 167. It could all change. Karen and Chris, come up the front. Let's play Double Money. It's Double Money, which means that all the answers are worth twice the price. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Surveyed 100 people, looking for the top five answers. Name a form of transport you'd be surprised to see the Queen using. Chris?
An old banger.
An old banger? You'd be surprised to see the Queen using an old banger? Our survey says... It's not there. Unlucky, Chris. Karen, name a form of transport you'd be surprised to see the Queen using.
A bicycle?
A bicycle. Wouldn't that be a good sight, though? There goes the Queen. A bicycle, our survey says... Yes, it's there, well done. Do you want to play or pass? We're going to play. OK, Chris, back to your family, start conferring. You might get another chance to steal. Jess, name a form of transport you'd be surprised to see the Queen using.
A motorbike.
A motorbike. You'd be surprised to see the Queen using a motorbike. Our survey says... Yes, well done. We've got all three lives intact. We only need three more answers, Fern, including the top answer. Name a form of transport you'd be surprised to see the Queen using.
Oh, well, I thought Jess was going to say this because he actually works for the Underground. A train.
A train?
Yeah.
All right, Fern's saying a train. Our survey says... Well done. Train, /tune. All three lives intact. Two more answers, please, Mick. Just give me one.
Bus.
A bus?
Yes.
You'd be surprised to see the Queen using a bus, says Mick. Our survey says... Yes, well done, top answer. What do you think, Lynn?
This is ridiculous. A skateboard.
Skateboard, a form of transport you'd be surprised to see the Queen using. It would be blooming surprising if you saw her on a skateboard. For the clean sweep, Lynn is saying a skateboard. Our survey says... Yeah! First round of double money. The Moyle family have got 73, but in the lead with 363, it's the Conn family. Jess and Kieran, come up the front and join me. Let's play Moyle's double money. Kieran, Jess, Kieran.
All right, Jess.
It's double money. All the answers are worth twice the price. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Look at the top five answers. Name something you might do if you ran out of clean pants. From experience, Kieran.
Turn them inside out.
Turn them inside out. All the fellas in the audience are going, yeah. Yeah. In fact. All right, turn them inside out. Our survey says... Yes, well done. It's not the top answer, though. Jess, what do you think?
Go commando.
Go commando.
Yeah.
Just forget about the pants. Jess is saying go commando. Our survey says... Oh!
Pass.
It's a tough category, they're going to pass. All right, go back to your family, you might get the chance to steal. Kieran, join the Moyles, no conferring. Hannah, before we go any further, let's find out a little bit more about your Christopher. Just tell us what he was like as a young boy, as an aspiring DJ, as a young whippersnapper.
He was always playing about with the radio and telling jokes.
Really?
Mm.
Well, we've got a picture of Chris. Ladies and gentlemen, take a look at this young man. Oh. Now, apparently that was during the Horsepipe ban in 1977.
Yes.
So cute!
Thanks, Mum!
Right, Chris, what do you think? Name something you might do if you ran out of clean pants.
Ruin your trousers.
Ruin your trousers? Are you serious?
Well, if you ran out of clean pants, you'd ruin your trousers.
Chris is saying ruin your trousers. Our survey says... It's not
there! I just wanted to hear the noise.
So, for them, something you might do if you ran out of clean pants?
Wash them.
Wash them?
Yeah.
It's so obvious.
Yes!
You notice when we said turn them inside out, Kieran, all the guys went, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sophie said, wash them. All the girls went, yeah. Yeah. All right, Sophie's saying wash them. Our survey said... Yes, well done. Well done, Sophie. Tonight, you are going home with this.
Hey, Sophie, you'll be the coolest lady in town after we've sent you and a friend 200 kilometres north of the Arctic Circle. You're going to Sweden's world-famous Ice Hotel. Yup, from the bar to the bedroom to the bathroom, everything is made out of ice. It's the one holiday where you won't be praying for sunshine in case it melts.
Hey, good job.
I really wanted to go there.
It's a bit nippy, though. Well done, congratulations. Right, Hannah, name something you might do if you ran out of clean pants. Now, I know that you have never done any of those answers.
Buy some more.
Buy some more. Hannah's saying buy some more. Our survey says... It's not there. It's not there. Chris, you've got one life left. We need two answers. What do you think?
Borrow the wives.
That's your dad. Your cross-dressing dad.
That's not ours.
All right. Yeah. Chris Senior is saying borrow the wives. Our survey says... Good answer, Chris. Well done. Kieran, what do you think? You've got one life left. You need one answer. Name something you might do if you ran out of clean pants.
Don't get out of bed.
Don't get out of bed, stay in bed. All right, Kieran's saying don't get out of bed because you've not got any clean pants whatsoever. Stay in, relax, enjoy yourself. Get a pizza in. Get on the phone, call your mates because you've got no clean underwear. It's the best excuse I've ever heard for a day in. Not there! All right, come family. Jeff, what do you think?
Use talcum powder.
You? Forget it. I'm not playing anymore. Use talcum powder. Tell me, Jess, that you've never, ever put talcum powder on your bits instead of pumps.
I've never.
Karen, how can you follow that?
Spraying with perfume.
With perfume, Lynn.
You could make a pair out of two hankies.
Nice.
Mick. Wear very long socks.
Very long socks.
Turn them back to front.
Turn them back to front. We've had inside out, but turn them back to front. Fern, you're the head of the family. What do you think? To steal from the Moyles family? I need an answer. You've had enough time to confirm.
Spray with aftershave.
Spray with aftershave. That's gotta hurt. All right, Fern is saying spray with aftershave. For the steal from the Moyles family, our survey says... it's not there! Well done, Chris. Well done. Let's have a look at that missing answer. What was it? We're dirty ones! We're dirty ones! Come on! Well, Chris, you did win that round, but unfortunately, it was too little...
It's a fix.
...too late.
It's a fix.
You think it's a fix?
I do.
I can tell you it would because you were all rubbish. Right, after that, ladies and gentlemen, we've taken Chris's score of 227. We've timed it by three, which means tonight, Chris, you are going home with £681 for the charity of your choice, plus that trip to the Ice Hotel. Ooh. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a massive round of applause. Welcome back to Family Fortunes. Now, before the break, we saw the Cottons win the main game, which means it's time for two of the family to play our big money final. Now, Fern, you are head of the family. Who are you going to take down to the hotspot?
My dad, right here.
All right, good luck. Mick and Fern, come and join me down there. Let's play for big money. Mick, Fern, wish you all the very best of luck. Between you, you need to get 200 points. If you do that, we'll give you £10,000 for the charity of your choice. If, however, you manage to get all top five answers between you, we'll give you another 20 grand, which means tonight you're playing for £30,000 for the charity of your choice. Wish you all the very best of luck. Fern, you're going to nip off.
You're in the zone. Look at me. He's concentrating.
I know. He's sight. You're going to nip off to our soundproof booth.
Right, goodbye.
We've got some Pavarotti for you.
Lovely.
Pavarotti with a bit of stomach trouble. So good luck with that. All right, Mick, I'm going to ask you five questions. You've got 15 seconds. Time starts when I finish the first question. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it at the end. Wish you all the very best of luck, Mick. You can have 15 seconds on the clock. Apart from a swimming costume, name something you might wear while swimming.
Bathing cap.
Name a city that has an underground rail system.
Paris Metro.
Name a stripy animal.
Tiger.
Name a fruit that requires peeling.
Orange.
Name something you might discuss with your hairdresser.
Colour of your hair.
All five answers in there, which is a good start. Now, it would be good, Mick, if we could get 100 or more with this first set of five answers. All right, wish you all the very best of luck. Let's see how you've done. Apart from a swimming costume, name something you might wear while swimming. You said... a bathing cap. Our survey said... 20. Name a city that's got an underground rail system. You said... the Paris Metro. Our survey said... 27. OK. a good start. Name a stripy animal. You said a tiger. Our survey said 22. That's a good score. We've got 69. It would be nice if we could get to 100 with these last two answers. Name a fruit that requires peeling. You said an orange. Our survey said 29. Well done. We're at 98. That's a good score. Name something you might discuss with your hairdresser. You said your hair. Our survey said 31. Well done. Everyone's 29. Well done, Nick. That's a very, very good score. Go back to your family. Thanks, let's man. Clear Thank the board you. And let's welcome back Fern Cotton. Fern, I can tell you, Dad got 129.
Which is good.
Very good. Good. Which means you need 71 to guarantee yourself £10,000. I'm going to ask you the same five questions.
OK.
All right? If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it at the end.
Right.
If you give me an answer that your dad's already given me, you'll hear this noise and we'll ask you for another answer. All right? Good luck. Now, because it's a little bit more difficult, we'll give you an extra 5 seconds, so you've got 20 seconds.
And I'm quite thick.
Well, you said that, not
Yeah, OK.
Now, let's remind the viewers at home of your dad's answers. And can I have 20 seconds on the clock? Apart from a swimming costume, name something you might wear while swimming.
A swimming hat.
Another answer.
Goggles.
Name a city that has an underground rail system.
Paris.
Another answer.
New York.
Name a stripy animal.
A zebra.
Name a fruit that requires peeling.
An apple.
Name something you might discuss with your hairdresser.
A colour.
Another answer.
Your holiday.
Well done. It's not as easy as people say it is.
Intense. Shake it out. Here we go.
All right, well, you did all right. Your dad got a really, really high score.
Okay.
So hopefully, fingers crossed, have managed 71. Let's turn around and have a look at the board. Right, good luck, Fern. Apart from a swimming costume, name something you might wear while swimming. You said goggles. Our survey said 56. Yeah. Well done. We've got 185. We only need 15 for £10,000. Was goggles the top answer? Yes, well done. Well done. Name a city that's got an underground rail system. You said New York. Our survey said 10.
Cool, okay, right.
We've got 195. We need 5 for that magic £210,000. But was Paris a top answer? No,
no,
it wasn't. I can tell you the top answer was London.
That would have been the obvious
people.
Answer. Good.
Why didn't you give it me?
I don't know.
All right, we can no longer go for £30,000, but we can still get £10,000 for your charity.
Okay.
Name a stripy animal. You said a zebra. We need 5 or more. Our survey said. Yeah! Well done, congratulations, Lynn. Well done, all the family, come down here. Let's just go over some of those top answers. Name a stripy animal, zebra was the top answer. Name a fruit that requires peeling, orange was the top answer. And name something you might discuss with your hairdresser. Mick, you said it, hair, that was the top answer. Well done.
Yeah.
You've won £10,000! And, of course, you've won the trip to go and feed the tigers and, Mick, you won the beautiful modern-day golf trolley. So, well done. They've been absolutely brilliant sports and have the Mileses. Please give both our families a massive round of applause. Good night! Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next time with more Family Fortunes. Good night!